My journey into entrepreneurship started many years ago. While I was serving, going to my community development center. On that walk, my life changed. It changed completely. I met a young boy. I had already passed him initially because he was in a building site. I didn't understand what a child should be doing at the building site. So I went back. I'm a very curious person. And I always like to ask a lot of questions. And I'm sure that's part of the reason I got to where I am, because I asked too many questions. So I stopped and I asked him, why are you here? Why are you not in school? And this young boy of 8 told me the sad story of disinheritance, of how his father died and the family swooped on them and took everything. It was very sad. But that set me on a journey. It set me on a course to discover, to research, to find ways to combat that. And while on that journey, one of the things that I came across is what we call cultural stereotypes. For us women, in order for us to build bridges in entrepreneurship, in business, in everything that we do, we must come against cultural stereotypes. Stereotypes that keep you in a box. Stereotypes that tell you you are not supposed to be there. You are not supposed to aspire to be on top. You are not supposed to be successful. You are supposed to be in a particular box. As women, if we are to build bridges, we must come out of that box. We must be able to show that those cultural
stereotypes are opportunities.
Opportunities. There are opportunities that we need to leverage on to move forward. And how do we leverage on such opportunities? What we do first is that we must create that thing that people will see. What do I mean? Change the narrative, change the framework. Show people. Because when you change the framework, when you get people to see differently, they begin to do differently. So it's important we change the framework. Another thing we must do is that we must change the narrative. The narrative that we have going for women is that women don't help other women. That's the narrative. And we need to debunk that. As I'm standing here, I'm standing on the shoulders of women who have gone before me. As I'm standing here, I'm standing on the opportunities of women who are ahead of me. As I'm standing here, I'm standing on the information that women gave me, and that's why I'm here. It's good to know that. So please, let us debunk the narrative that women don't help each other. Another issue I noticed working as an entrepreneur is the business arena. The business arena for women. It's very lonely. It's a male-dominated arena. And what has happened is that in that arena, we feel lonely. We feel alone, we feel left out. And that's why we must build allies. Build allies among yourselves. So that when your power is down, you have that person that can come to you and build you up again. Make sure you have allies. It's very important. And then, aside from building allies, we have a lot of resources all over. There are online platforms that women can leverage on. I, for one, I became an Ashoka Fellow in 2002. That was information given to me at the time that I needed it. And becoming an Ashoka Fellow, what it did for me is that it opened doors of endorsement. It opened doors of engagement. It opened doors of funding. So whenever I stepped on any podium or anywhere I'm going, they could see the huge family of Ashoka behind me, and those doors will open. So I'm challenging women today. Don't allow opportunities to pass you by. Check out the online opportunities that we have. There are several. We have a lot of online opportunities that will lead you into launching your idea and moving forward. We also have offline opportunities, and that's where your allies come in. People that can share timely information with you. at the time that you need it. Because information can just, that information you will get at that crucial time might be what will take you to the next level in your idea. So we need information, so let's share with one another. Another thing we must do, aside from sharing, is build yourself up. Set up a structure. Don't do things haphazardly. There's something that happens to us sometimes as women. We want to play the female card when it comes to it. But I'm charging us today, let's stop playing the female card. Let's show everyone that cares to know we are capable. We have what it takes. We have the expertise. We have it and we know it. Because if you don't show that expertise, if you don't show that you can do it and you are playing the female card, they will not take us serious. And we need to move that, we need to change that narrative. And it is important that we work together. What are your networks? Are you in a network? Do you believe in it? Because one thing that happens when you are in a network is that you share resources. So be part of a network. Don't be in a network and you are not really part of it. What do I mean? Sometimes you're in a network, but you are not sharing information. Be in a network and be the one that is also bringing information for other women to grow. It's very important. We need to grow. We already know that there's a large divide between the female child and the male child in every aspect. Is it in technology? Is it in business? Is it in entrepreneurship? So whatever resources we can gather, whatever resources we can use, let's try and ensure that we are using those resources to upgrade a lot of women all over the world. And you know what? I'm so happy, I'm so excited, because I know we can do it. I know we have that power. I know we have that expertise. I know we have the capacity to build those bridges and ensure that the women coming after us will not go through the challenges we are in. And we have to make sure that we so level the walls. You know, you will level the walls completely so that the women coming after us will just have an enabling environment to try, to soar, to excel, and to achieve all that they have set out to. Let's do it together. Thank you.